For former president of the Principals Association, Cyrus Sipal, who now serves as principal of the Seventh-day Adventist Academy, student loitering in the city of Castries, particularly on Fridays, has to stop, even if it involves principals making their physical presence felt in the city to get the youngsters off the streets. Already, businesses within the Blue Coral Mall have written to the principals articulating their concerns. Mr. Sipal says after-school programs have been organized, but apparently these programs need to be revisited.
I know principals have been talking to the students about that, but I think it might reach to the point where we will have to go to Castries physically and then get our students out, or we may have to have the parents to sign a contract on behalf of the children that, listen, at certain time of the day, you're not supposed to be in Castries. Now, at the same time, you have to take into consideration there are students genuinely who may have to take extra lessons, or who may have to be in Castries to run an errand for their parents. Now, these children find themselves with those who are loitering, and that's where the problem comes in.
The other part of the problem, according to Mr. Sipal, is that in most households, there are single parents who work outside the home, and as a result, there is no one to monitor the youngsters. He says the authorities may even have to consider getting parents to sign documentation, which prohibits the children from roaming the city at a certain time. Sipal says the organizations like the churches and community centers can be used to engage the youngsters in meaningful activity.
The days when you had parents who were home, let us say the father would go to work and the mother would be at home, so therefore that child, after ending the school day, you had to be at home at a certain time, so therefore this was not a problem. But then now, where you have a lot of single parent families, and where you have, if it is just the father has to work, or just if it is the mother has to work, and sometimes she has to work two jobs. Now, in such a situation, the child may not be able to go back home to find somebody who can supervise them.
When it comes to disrespect for authority, Mr. Sipal says this cannot and will not be tolerated. Law enforcement agencies are also discussing methods to bring the situation of student loitering under control. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.